Clarion is a small community of approximately 6,000 residents nestled in the wooded hills of western Pennsylvania, where football reigns supreme. The region has produced NFL greats Joe Namath, Joe Montana, Dan Marino, and Jim Kelly. Nearly 2 hours northeast of Pittsburgh, Clarion is the home of the Clarion University Golden Eagles, who in 1996 set a school record with 11 wins against just 2 losses. Memorial Stadium, its field soft, muddy, and chewed up, was the site of the Division II semifinals between number 15 Northern Colorado and number 8 Clarion. The Golden Eagles led all of Division II by scoring 41.8 points per game and featured the talents of all-time leading rusher Steve Whitty, 1,293 yards and 16 touchdowns in 1996, and Ron DeGitis, 1,198 yards and 6 scores. In addition, quarterback Chris Weibel had thrown for 2,524 yards and 30 touchdowns entering the showdown with Northern Colorado. A 15-yard chop block penalty helped stall the Golden Eagles' first drive. After a UNC punt, Clarion moved from its 26 to the Bears' 44-yard line before the UNC defense stopped the Golden Eagles.
Third and a long two from the 44 of Northern Colorado. Backs are split behind Weibel. It'll be a play action. He wants to throw, flush to the left side. He's in trouble, and Monroe brings him down by the back of the jersey back in Clarion territory at about the 47.
While Brian Monroe's sack forced a Clarion punt, the Bears' two-time first-team All-NCC linebacker would sit out the rest of the game with a separated shoulder sustained on the play. The two teams went to the second quarter locked at nothing-nothing before UNC hit for one of its big plays.
Kinzinger left. Casco right, eyes set. Now Casco in motion to the left on second and 5 from the 25. Beck to run option, pitches to Holmes right side, 25, has an alley 30, down the sideline 35 to the 40, still going at the 50-yard line, and he's pushed out of bounds.
Despite Billy Holmes' 24-yard run, UNC could not score on that possession and punted back to Clarion. It took the Golden Eagles 11 plays, 4 minutes and 28 seconds to move 60 yards for the game's first touchdown.
The Bear defense breaks huddle and digs into the muddy grass on the goal line. Golden Eagles with the full house tee. Steve Whitty, Ron DeGitis, and Jamie Sicari side by side behind Weibel. Second and goal from inside the one. Weibel barking out signals, turns over the top. DeGitis, touchdown Clarion. 6-0 Golden Eagles with 8:12 to go in the first half. DeGitis scoring his 7th touchdown of the season.
Tyler Pallison's PAT was wide, though, and Clarion's lead held at 6-0. On its next drive, UNC turned again to All-NCC tailback Billy Holmes.
Backs are split. Keith Grable in motion right. To the left, it's Zuniga. Second and 10 from the 24. Holmes on the counter, right side. Stumbles ahead. He's past the 30. Outside right to the 40. Billy down the sideline to the 50. To the Clarion 40. Cuts back to the 30. And he's written down at the 28-yard line.
Holmes' 49-yard run brought the Bears into Golden Eagles territory. And after a first down at the Clarion 17, a clipping penalty moved UNC back to the 32. No big deal for the Bears.
Fourth and 5 Bears at the Golden Eagle 22. Keith Grable split to the right. Omar Zuniga left. Now Grable in motion to the left. Straight eye. Holmes dotting it behind Ciccarelli. Option right. Beck will keep. Gets out of a tackle. Hurdles across the 20. And he's out of bounds near the sticks. It'll be close on the spot. It looks like the spot is between the 17 and 18. Boy, they'll stretch the chains right there. And now they'll need to measure, actually. First down by half the football. It will be first down and 25. Ball on the left hash. Steve Kinzinger to the left. Keith Grable in the slot that way. Holmes and Ciccarelli split behind Tom Beck, who flips up Frazier's towel, and Beck will drop back to throw. Deep drop beyond the 40, lofts it down the left sideline. Ciccarelli's open, makes the catch at the 10, and he steps out right there. He would have scored if he could have kept his balance. But as it is, it's a 22-yard gain, and it brings up second and short. How did he get so open? Second and three from the 10. I set Holmes and Ciccarelli. Keith Grable, a receiver, left, two tight ends. Option to the right. Beck to fake pitch. He'll go to the five, into the corner of the end zone, and Northern Colorado has tied it at six with 6:17 to go in the second quarter. Tom Beck runs it in for the eighth time this year, and the Bears can take the lead with the PAT.
But Northern Colorado's Mike Schauer pulled his extra point attempt to the left, and the score remained tied at six. Not to be outdone, the Golden Eagles put together a 10-play, 79-yard scoring drive to retake the lead.
First and 10 from the 21. Sakari, the wing to the right. Steve Witte, wing to the left. He'll get the call up the middle. Has open room to the 25, to the 30, and he leaps ahead and gets tackled by Roberson at the 34-yard line. Third and 5 from the 50. Mark Witte to the right. Steve Witte, a wing to the left. DeGitis and Sakari split as the running backs behind Weibel. Now Steve Witte in motion to the right side, and Weibel wants to throw. Good protection. Left flat. He's got Sakari at the 45, 50. Down the sideline. He gets bumped out by Delano Washington inside the 40, near the 35, and that'll be enough for the first down. Fourth down and 8 from the Bear 33, and the Eagles will go for it with 2:42 to go before half in a 6-6 game. Mark Witte right, Alvin Slaughter left. A wing to either side. DeGitis the lone setback. Chris Weibel with a straight drop. Looking to the right. Fires it. He's got Mark Witte at the 20. Ahead to the 10. To the 5. Touchdown, Golden Eagles. Woo! 2:34 left before half, and the Golden Eagles lead it 12-6, converting on 4th and 8. A 33-yard strike to Mark Witte. It's Weibel's 31st touchdown pass and Witte's third touchdown reception.
It stayed 12-6 after Clarion's two-point conversion pass was incomplete. After a UNC punt, the Golden Eagles tried to post one more score before halftime.
First and 10, Golden Eagles own 40, a wing T set, one setback to Jitis. Middle screen taken by Slaughter, 45, flag down 50, slips as he gets across midfield, fumbles the ball in Bear territory. Northern Colorado's on it. Aaron Smith recovers.
The penalty was against Clarion, and with 1:26 left in the second, the Bears went right to work.
UNC at its own 45-yard line.
Bears have two timeouts left, Mike.
To the left, Omar Zuniga. Slot left is Keith Grable. Ciccarelli and Holmes in the pro set behind Beck. Ball on the right hash, or what's left of it. Here's Beck to throw. Everybody rushing. He slips, steps up in the pocket. Right side, he has Keith Grable at the 45. Cuts back at the Clarion 40. Free down the sideline to the 30. He rumbles out of bounds inside the 25 at the 23. First and 10 from the 23. Beck over the middle has Ciccarelli at the 20. Ahead to the 10, and he bucks heads and gets to the 9-yard line.
But it was Clarion's defense that came up with the big play and kept UNC off the scoreboard.
First and goal, call it the 10. Zuniga left, Keith Grable right, Holmes and Ciccarelli in the eye. Beck will turn, early pitch right side to Holmes, who lost it, and the Eagles are on the football. Kim Niabella, the All-America safety, recovers the fumble with 54 seconds left in the second quarter. That one hurts.
On its first possession of the third quarter, Clarion built on its 12-6 advantage.
Golden Eagles now with a second and 17 back at their own 42. But this offense doesn't score 42 points a game for nothing. I don't think they're going to get close to that today, Scott. But we've seen they are very good any situation down in distance. Split backs behind Weibel. Wide to the right is Slaughter. Wing that way is Sakari. Turn and Weibel with a straight drop. Over the middle has Steve Witte. Runs left to the 45, to midfield, down the left sideline to the 40, to the 30. Still loose at the 30, 25, to the 20. He's to the 10. Steve Witte scores the Clarion touchdown. 18-6 Golden Eagles with 9:15 to go in the third. 58 yards. His sixth touchdown reception of the year. And it's a 12-point edge for Clarion.
Again, Clarion's two-point conversion pass failed. Desperately needing a score to get back in the game, the Bears, on their next possession, came through on their only two third-down conversions of the game.
Third and 2 from the 50. Backs are split. Beck will throw. Good protection. Now he drifts to the right. Lofts it down the right sideline. Lusk with a leaping grab at the 25, and he rolls out of bounds. What a play by the junior.
And the Bears have it first and 10 at the 25 on the 25-yard connection.
Omar Zuniga left, Keith Grable to the right. Holmes and Ciccarelli side by side behind Beck. Third and 7 from the 8. Keith Grable in motion to the left. Taps Beck on the way by. Time to throw. Here comes the blitz. Left side. He wants Keith Grable. It is caught. Touchdown, Northern Colorado. One-on-one coverage, and Grable was able to get the better of Wisner. And the Bears are within 18-12 with 5:45 to go in the third period.
Showers point after pulled UNC to within 18-13. In the fourth quarter, UNC tested the Clarion defense on 4.5 yards just outside the UNC 29-yard line.
Two tight ends, a wing to the right, Keith Grable. Holmes and Ciccarelli split behind Beck. Beck over right guard. It is close. I don't think he got it.
Yeah, they didn't give it to him. The official put the spot down short of the stripe. That's all it takes. I'm not sure they got a good look at it, but they have not given UNC a first down. They have marked it short of the 30-yard stripe.
The Golden Eagles moved from the Bears 29 to the 9 before trying a short field goal.
It will be Frank Van Wart, the sophomore from Library, Pennsylvania, has not tried a field goal this year. Out of Forney's hold from the right hash mark, a 27-yarder to give Clarion an 8-point lead. Everybody's set. Forney matting down the spot. Snap, place down, kick is on the way, and it's no good, wide to the left. And with 7:29 to go, Clarion still leads 18-13.
The Northern Colorado defense had come up with another huge stop, and the offense looked to pick it up.
Second and 11 from the 19, offset eye behind Beck. It'll be a play action. Tom will throw. Looking, deep down the right sideline. Ciccarelli open at the 50. He's to the 45 and dives to the 43 of Clarion. Wrapped up by Wisner and Niabella.
Second time in the game, Ciccarelli has gotten wide open on that sideline, Mike. The last time he had to make a great catch on the sideline. This time he had a little more room to work with, but again, credit the time up front provided by the offensive line, because Beck, that play takes a long time to develop, and Tom Beck needed and received the necessary time to find Ciccarelli.
His longest reception of the year.
The next three plays gained almost 10 yards, and UNC tried again on fourth and very short.
Fourth and inches for the Bears at the Clarion 35. Down 18-13 with 5:35 to go in the fourth quarter. Ciccarelli and Holmes in the eye. Two tight ends set. Keith Grable a wing to the right. Beck under center. Eagles stack the line. Turn. Billy Holmes fumbled the ball. Taking it there are the Eagles. Running back to the 40 to the 45 of Clarion. Kawan Colbreth recovered, and the Eagles stop again on fourth and inches. Incredible.
5 minutes and 28 seconds left, and Northern Colorado still trailed 18-13. All Clarion needed to do was pick up a first down or two. Easier said than done against the UNC defense.
I think if Clarion doesn't make it here, they would punt it away and make the Bears go virtually the length of the field.
Yeah, I think it's critical here for UNC to stop right here, because they can't, the way Clarion runs the football, they can't allow them to pick up one or two first downs on this drive. They have to stop Clarion here and try to get that football back to its offense.
Third and 6 at the Golden Eagle 49. DeJitis and Steve Woody split behind Weibel. Wing to the right, Sakari. Weibel will throw. Looking left, out of the backfield. Caught by Steve Woody, short of the first down as he's wrapped up by Delano Washington at the Bear 48 or 47-yard line.
Yeah, he's at least 2 yards shy of the first down. I think you've got to punt this football if you're Clarion.
That's exactly what the Golden Eagles did. 3 minutes, 4 seconds remaining. Clarion 18, Northern Colorado 13. UNC needed another dramatic drive to pull the game out. The ball went into the hands of UNC's Captain Clutch, senior quarterback Tom Beck.
In the national championship game is on the line. UNC will start first and 10, moving left to right. Sun shining momentarily now at Memorial Stadium. The turf chewed up, ruddy, muddy, but Northern Colorado is 74 yards away from going to the national championship in Florence, Alabama next Saturday. First and 10 Bears. Do they have another huge drive late in the playoffs? Keith Grable and Zuniga left. Now Grable in motion to the right. Holmes and Ciccarelli offset in the eye. Beck on the counter gives to Holmes. Drilled at the 22-yard line. Shooting through was Wayne Alling, the defensive end. Loss of four. 2:52 to go. Bears really in no hurry. Actually, they'll mark him down back at the 21-yard line.
That play was a counter. And the guy just came around the end. It just came down real hard. And we weren't able to get a body on him, and Billy got hit on it. But we thought that we had a good shot to, by the way they were playing, that get some linemen up there and get Billy up in the line. But didn't work out for us.
Bears with all three timeouts. Tom Beck looking at the sideline. Play clock at 19 as the senior, the leader, the veteran of this team looks to pull it out one more time.
Mike, the Bears have to find a way to slow down that defensive line rush.
And now the Bears need to call timeout with 2:28 left and the play clock at 5. 2:28 remaining. We will keep it here. Clarion 18, Northern Colorado 13, as Tom Beck walks to the far sideline to talk with his coach, Joe Glenn. A player, Tom Beck, whom Joe Glenn calls more than special. Kay Dalton, who has been in coaching for more than 40 years, the Bears offensive coordinator, including several stints in the NFL, says in the leadership department, Tom Beck is the best quarterback, college quarterback he's ever coached. And right now they need his leadership and they need the rest of the guys to execute what is now a 79-yard field in front of them. 18-13, Clarion leads with 2:28 to go.
Mike, all you can do on the road is to ask for a chance to win the game at the end, and the Bears have that chance. A touchdown here would put them ahead, probably would be the winning touchdown. But again, a long way to go on a sloppy field. The Bears, it's going to take more than one big play. It's going to take a series of big offensive plays.
Ozzie and Keith Grable left, Zuniga right. Backs are split on second and 14 from the 21. Beck to throw, left side has Ciccarelli. Ahead to the 20, trying to get out of bounds. Gets away to the 25, down the sideline to the 30. He leaps over the 40-yard line, and he has a first down out near the 45. He did it all by himself. Gain of 24 yards, 2:16 remaining. Beck to Ciccarelli, one big play down. But Northern Colorado, as Scott said, has more work to do. They'll mark Ciccarelli all the way to the 47, a gain of 26.
Ciccarelli checks his linebackers, see if they're coming. They weren't coming. I had comebacks on the outside and the tight end running down the middle. They really flew out of there, and Ciccarelli just checks, and then he just kind of runs a little flare route. And I saw him open, I hit it, and then the rest of it's Ciccarelli's. I threw it about 3 yards, and he... you know, he ran the rest of the way. He did a great job running the ball.
First and 10 Bears. To the left, it is Kenzinger. To the right, Keith Grable. Offset eye with Holmes, the fullback. Beck to sprint out on first and 10. Pump fake, looks back to the left. He wants Holmes down the sideline. Has it at the 20. He's down to the 10-yard line.
Boy, what a play call. Beck sprints out to the right side. The defense kind of collapsed on Keith Grable, who Tom Beck had on his half of the field about 15 yards. The whole time, Billy Holmes streaking down the left sideline. Beck turns to his left, makes the John Elway type across the field throw, and Holmes makes the catch. They're inside, or at least close to the 10. Unbelievable play.
Coach Dalton, he said that about the third quarter, he was like, hey, when I call this play, he goes, if the Z isn't wide open, then I want you to look for Billy because he's going to be open down the side. We hit Billy and Ciccarelli, or I think Ciccarelli twice earlier in the game coming down the sides from the backfield. And so what it is, it's a zero-week fire boot right Z square out. And all it is, I'm kind of rolling out behind the tackle. We got a square out by Z. We got X hooking over the ball, and we got the tailback running an out and up. And Billy had that guy man for man, and you know, Billy has great speed. He's one of the fastest guys on our team, so I knew that he'd be able to get out there and get it.
First and 10 from the 11, 1:49 to go, clock rolling. Bears down 18-13. Will they go to the national championship? Daniels behind Ciccarelli in the eye. Give it to Daniels. Sweeping right. Fumble the ball. Loose.
Second
Who
down.
Has it?
UNC's got it back. Second down.
Oh, my goodness. Timeout taken by the Bears as I think Daniels got back on it. And we will keep it here to try and recompose with 1:32. Daniels got popped. I'm not sure which Golden Eagle came in, but Northern Colorado dodges a major disaster. The season riding on that loose pigskin. But the Bears scrap in the mud and don't lose a thing. It'll be second. Actually, they do. Let's call it second down and 14 from the 15 with 1:32 to go.
I was standing back there after I faked and I saw that thing go up. And, I mean, that was scary because, you know, we just did it the series before where we fumbled. And, you know, it was one of those things that, man, it really made us. It makes us appreciate it. When you're about to lose something, you really appreciate it. And, you know, so we really appreciate this victory and, you know, the winning the game and coming down at the end.
Did West recover that?
I think West fell back on top of him, and Chad Ansel fell back on top of him. So, yeah, West was the one that ended up having it underneath there.
But field goal does the Bears no good. They trail 18-13. This team has had a penchant for the dramatic, a flair for the incredible in the playoffs. And Northern Colorado is looking to pull off its third consecutive unbelievable close finish down at the wire. Beck slops through the gushy mud back to the huddle. Ball right at the 15-yard line.
Time not the factor, Mike. Bears have one timeout, a minute and a half. The key in this, obviously, is they've got three plays to try to pick up 15 yards.
Second down and 11 from the 15. Keith Grable right, Omar Zuniga left. Wing back to the right is Lusk. Holmes alone behind Beck. Under center facing the four-man front. The senior back to pass. Deep drop. Left side in the corner. Out there it is. Caught by Zuniga. Touchdown Northern Colorado with 1:25 to go.
I have no idea where Omar Zuniga came from, but he was so wide open, Mike. There was not a clarion defender within 10 yards. Tom Beck had plenty of time to throw. Zuniga back in the left corner of that end zone, back by the post. And I have no idea where the breakdown came, but the Bears will take it. He was so wide open. The only question was, would he catch the football?
19-18 Bears.
This is called two wing, 60 double cross X shake. And actually, I called that play. I'm going to take credit for that one instead of giving it to coach. I called that one. And I knew that they tried to go man. And I knew Omar, he runs that route real well. It's a post corner. And I knew they were going to go man. And the safety wasn't going to be able to help it. So all Omar had to do was beat that one guy. And also, Omar's taller than that guy. So I knew if worst came to worst, I was going to throw it up there, let him use his big, strong physical body and get it. And he ended up, when he ran that post hard, I told him in the huddle, I said, make sure you give a hard fake on that post and you'll be wide open. He went in there hard, and when he came back out in the corner, I don't think the guy was within 5 yards of him.
No, and you seemed to drift to the right. Do you think that pulled the coverage to your side a little bit?
Yeah, I think it did. I really tried to look him off. I really tried to look over there to the right, and I kind of came over to the right a little bit. But I was trying to look at my two tight ends, because if Omar wasn't open, I had them coming across the field. And I was trying to look over there and really make sure that the safety couldn't get over the top.
The whole game they were playing tight man, so I think that's the reason Tom called that play, was because there's no way that a DB can cover a double cut route, because the DB just bit on the post route and it just left me wide open. I don't know how I got that way.
Did the ball again seem to take forever to get there?
I think this time it took longer. Yeah, I don't know. The one thing I was worrying about is staying in bounds. That's all I worried about.
After the unsuccessful two-point conversion, the Bears still led 19-18 thanks to their five-play, 75-yard drive, which took 1 minute and 39 seconds off the clock. But there was plenty of drama left. Starting from their own 26, the Golden Eagles look to pull off their own miracle in the mud.
Let's see now if the UNC defense that has played just outstanding football this fourth quarter has one more big stop in them. Now it's Clarion's turn. to try to come up with a fantastic finish.
Are they a national title caliber team? Does Clarion have what it takes against a salty UNC defense? 1:19 remaining. Golden Eagles have two timeouts left, and they will go right to left, first and 10, own 26. We've seen the Bears come up with big drives now in the last three games. Do the Eagles have an answer behind junior quarterback Chris Weibel? Over 2,500 yards passing coming in. He's under center, the wing tee behind him. Mark Whitty, a receiver left, Alvin Slaughter to the right. Back to pass, Weibel at his 20. Plenty of time over the middle. It is incomplete to Whitty, broken up by Bunning at the 37. There was a little contact, but apparently after the ball had arrived, it was bang, bang. 1:14 to go, 19-18, Bears lead it. Golden Eagles, second and 10, own 26. Wing back to the left is Steve Whitty. Wing to the right, Sakari. Lone setback to Jitus. A receiver to either side on second and 10. Weibel to throw. Blitz on. Middle screen taken there. It's chopped down by Jim Porter and company at the 31-yard line as the pass came in to the Golden Eagles. Taking the pass was Rich Kindle, and it will be third down and 5 from the 31. No huddle for the Eagles, 56 seconds to go. Wing T formation, Weibel to throw. Looking over the middle, has DeGitis at the 35, and he's short of the first.
He's short of the first, although they may, well, I think timeout now, Clarion.
Timeout, Golden Eagles with 47 seconds to go. 19-18, Northern Colorado leads. We will keep it here.
Mike, I'm not sure if they've, I think they're just seeing, I'm not sure if they called timeout or if they're just stopping the clock to see if it's possibly a first down.
Oh, it is a timeout for a measurement. And Scott, the where the third down marker was clearly short, although the sideline is very muddy where the markers are on the far side, and they will bring the chains across, stretch it out, and they have a first down.
Wow.
Wow, that was... apparently caught us, and a good job by the officials to call for that.
You bet. Good job by the officials, because it looked like it was about a yard short, and the officials right on top of it stopped the clock, and Clarion now, 47 seconds left.
Trailing 19-18. First and 10, own 36. Weibel with DeGitis behind him, three receivers right, one to the left. Weibel takes the snap, drops back, slant in, caught by Steve Whitty across the 45, and he will be pummeled back by Bunning along with Delano Washington and Brian Scott. That'll be close to another first down. 37 seconds to go. They move the sticks. Bears lead 19-18. Florence, Alabama, 37 seconds away for the Bears. Clarion trying to answer the Bears' late game dramatics. Three receivers right, one to the left. First and 10, own 47. Weibel to throw. Deep down the right side. It is a diving try and through Slaughter's hands at the 36 and incomplete. Second down, 10 from the 47. 29 seconds to go. Clarion down by one. Lone setback is DeGitis. Triples to the right. One receiver left. Weibel drops back again. Now steps up. Feeling the heat. Spins and he will go down. Hey, the ball taken
Lopez,
away by Denzel Lopez. He took it away, but no signal. They will
move
Weibel down at the 46. Progress stopped as Lopez ripped the ball away, and with 16 seconds to go, timeout on the field.
On the way down, Lopez able to rip that football out of his grasp, but probably a good call by the official. His momentum was stopped, and the Bears, as it is, will take a sack. It's going to be third down and long, Mike, and now you're in the situation where with only 16 seconds left and Clarion out of timeouts, you would think it's going to be awfully tough unless they have some kind of long pass play. But first, they have to worry about picking up the first down again.
Western Pennsylvania, known for its football tradition. It has produced NFL greats. None of these Clarion players will be one of those, but the Golden Eagles looking to keep their season alive. Third down and 11 from their own 46-yard line. 16 seconds to go. Bears 19, Golden Eagles 18. Bears defense is ready. Two plays left, maybe, for the Golden Eagles. Sakari, Mark Whitty to the right. Steve Whitty to the left. DeGitis alone behind Weibel. Third and long, Bears rush four. Weibel wants to throw. Wants to go deep down the left side for Whitty. It is caught inside the 15.
left. He's at the 13-yard line. He was one-on-one with Delano Washington. The Golden Eagles will apparently spike it down with 9 seconds to go. First down being motion. Clock yet to roll. Everybody set. First and 10 from the 13. Golden Eagles down 19-18. Two receivers left, and Weibel spikes it into the ground with 6 seconds to go. And Scott, one would think that the Golden Eagles have 2 plays left.
I think they're going to kick a field goal right here, Mike.
19-18. Tyler Pallison will try the field goal. 5'9", 160-pound junior, left-footed kicker. 4 of 7 this year. He's missed an extra point today. Left hash mark will be the spot, and a timeout taken by UNC. Steve Whitty made a dramatic spinning catch down the left sideline. They will mark it actually at about the 14, I believe, and Tyler Pallison comes back to the near sideline, and he and Mike Forney will try a couple of practice kicks into the net. Well, Mike Schauer, the Bears redshirt freshman, was able to come through against Pitt State. Pallison will now make his way back out onto the field. Last year he was 8 of 8, but his long was 31 yards. He is fired up, slapping himself on the right side of the helmet. Mike Forney will hold, left hash mark from the 21-yard line. A 31-yard attempt, national title hopes on the line, a trip to the title game riding on this kick. The left footer taps his toe twice into the mud. Forney looking down at the spot, reaching for the snap. Place down, kick is on the way, it is tipped, it is short, and Northern Colorado has come to the land where football is king and taken the Golden Eagles off their perch. 19-18, Northern Colorado will play for the Division II National Championship. 1 second left officially. Somebody got a hand on it. Flags are down. A dejected group of Eagles comes to the near side while the Bears' celebration continues across the field. Can you believe that? 19-18 Bears. 1 second remaining. Ball at the 10. Northern Colorado simply has to snap it, and they can pack their bags for Florence. An incredible season will apparently culminate in a shot at the national championship against the Carson Newman, Cal Davis winner. Bears line up at their 10. Ciccarelli and Holmes and Grable back at the goal line. Beck puts the knee down, and the Bears are on their way to Alabama. The players come out onto the field after a heart-stopping 19-18 win over Clarion in the semifinals at Memorial Stadium in Clarion, Pennsylvania. Hugs all around, high fives the order of the afternoon for the Northern Colorado Bears as they will make their first ever trip to the national championship. They have never won a national championship in a team sport, and they will have a chance to do it in football in 1996. 19-18, Northern Colorado beats Clarion thanks to a 4-play, 74-yard drive culminated by the 15-yard touchdown pass from Tom Beck to Omar Zuniga with 1:25 remaining. And Northern Colorado has pushed the 96 season to the limit. It will all be on the line in Florence next week. My goodness, 3 straight dramatic finishes in the playoffs for the UNC Bears leave many wondering if this is not the year. We will have a complete wrap-up of this one. Players, head coach Joe Glenn to join us,
And talk about a trip to the national championship. The Bears and Eagles exchange five on the chopped up muddy turf at Memorial Stadium, which has seen its last game in the 96 season. And it sees the visiting team walk away with a one-point win. Three wins in the postseason by a total of 5 points for the UNC Bears. Simply unbelievable. 19-18. I'm not sure who got a hand on that field goal by Tyler Pallison, but nonetheless, the Northern Colorado Bears survive to play one final week in the 96 season. Northern Colorado 19, Clarion 18. Get used to the sound. The Bears are playing for the national title.
UNC cornerback Delano Washington was the player who tipped Pallison's field goal and secured the Bears' spot in the title game in Florence.
You hear the crowd roaring and stuff. I mean, after the big play, the long deep pass that I gave up, and my friends come over and they're just like, you just got to redeem yourself. He's like, here's your chance. You know, this is what can make you an All-American. And this would, can make you, one of the better players. And he said, here's your chance, to step up. And so, everybody comes to the line and you're sitting down there and you're just thinking, I just got to get a jump on this ball. Got to get a jump on this ball. Getting your footing, your footing right and everything. So you take off and I turned that corner and laid out and got a block off of my index and my middle finger. Those are the lucky two fingers, so I don't know. And then that's about what happened towards the end. I mean, it's just, I don't know, it was just one of the most spectacular plays of my life, so that's about it.
What thought do you remember having first when you see the ball in the end zone and realize that you did block the kick and save the game?
I just know that once I dove for that ball and I heard it tip off my fingers, I knew that either I blocked it or either it was just going to have enough momentum to either sail right or it was going to go through. And once I dove, I kind of like put my head down, and right when I looked up, the ball just died in the air and hit, I think it hit around inside the touchdown somewhere. And that's when I got up and ran over to the bench, and I was just like, thank you, Jesus, for giving me the strength, to pick myself up like that.
Once again, they just no quit, Mike. I thought maybe early on they had a little too much for us and seemed to be dominating the line of scrimmage, and we were making too many tackles out of the secondary and scared me because, that can wear you down. But as the game came on, our offense started to pick it up a little bit and our front seven seemed to be finding the football a little bit better, and the Bears started getting a little momentum and picked it up and just had enough to win.
Coach, how does it feel now to be packing your bags for a place called Florence, Alabama?
We're all kind of down the field pinching each other, right? Don't know how to act. This is exciting. I don't think a lot of the kids really it's soaked in yet. it's a great opportunity for our team and our coaches, but I really think a real proud moment for our university and our town, the great city of Greeley. We're all going down there and carrying our colors and going to be on national TV. And we have a friend back in the Greeley Hospital that we're carrying his colors too, Dan Libera, a big part of this. He brought a lot of these kids in here. And Dan, we're all pulling for you up there, buddy. And keep cheering us on. We can feel your spirit all the way from your room up there at the hospital. But it just, Mike, I don't know what it is about this team. You said it, I think, about a month ago, that they are just on a team of destiny. And I don't know how to respond to that, and I never have, but whatever that means, we must be getting close to whatever destiny is, huh?
This is the greatest. I'm just sitting here in awe right now. I don't know what to say. It's just one of the greatest. It is probably one of the greatest feelings I've ever had, and I'm so excited to finally get to go there and get a chance to be playing for a national championship. This has always been my dream, and now it finally gets to come true for all of us, and I think a lot of us have worked hard, and it's nice that we get the chance to play for the national championship, represent our school, our family, and just the whole football team and program.
Tom, do you look back now over the Pitt game, Northwest game, and now a short time ago this game, and say, how did I just do, or how did we just do what we just did?
Yeah, there's sometimes, I mean, it's amazing. I don't know how we keep moving the ball down the field late in the game and winning the game like this. I mean, I guess it's I mean, you got to put the credit back on the coaching. They've coached us up well, but it's just everyone believing. And I think the good Lord up above us is putting his hand on us, and he's carrying us through these games right now.
For the second consecutive week, quarterback Tom Beck guided the Bears on a last-gasp drive to the game-winning points.
Well, again, Tom, the same question I asked you last week. Was there anything said? What was your disposition, your demeanor on the field as you entered the huddle?
Well, this week I think it was really good that we won last week in the final minutes, because I came in the huddle and I said, look, fellas, so we did the same thing last week. I go, but we had a lot less time. We have about half the time that we have now, so we know we can do it. So now it's just believe in ourselves, and we're going to go out there and win this game. And when I said that, I mean, it just looked like everyone was like, yeah, we really are going to win this game. And they really believed, because they were like, yeah, we did win last week. And Tony Ramirez told me down there, he said, once you came in the huddle and started saying that, I think, all right, great, we're going to go down and win this game again and make it close. So it was fun, though. I mean, everyone is really believing now, and, I mean, I don't think you can put the quit, you know, out of us.
It goes beyond now just a one- or two-game thing. This has become miraculous.
Yeah, I mean, God's looking over us, and that's about all I could say about that, because keep putting us in these opportunities and keep letting us come out on top. I know we got a lot of guys that believe, a lot of guys that never say die, but this is the greatest feeling is right now. I think I just telling Omar, the only feeling that's going to beat this right now is next week about this time for a champion, national champions. But I can't explain how we keep winning these games late, how they keep coming out. Everyone keeps telling me next week, let's see if we can win by couple more points than one and not late in the game. Save our heart a little bit.
Northern Colorado 19, Clarion 18. In the end, Clarion could only kick itself for missing out on a trip to the national championship. The Golden Eagles missed an extra point, field goals of 27 and 31 yards, and 2 2-point conversions. Meanwhile, Northern Colorado's postseason had reached epic proportions. The Bears had won 3 playoff games by 5 points. In addition, a total of 1 minute and 38 seconds remained on the clock when UNC scored the go-ahead points. The Northern Colorado Bears were headed to Brawley Municipal Stadium in Florence, Alabama, to play the Carson Newman Eagles from Jefferson City, Tennessee, for the Division II National Championship. There is more to come on The Bears Find a Way on 1310 KFKA. Is a source of seemingly limitless energy, limitless potential, and limitless accomplishment. It is a time when nothing matters, yet everything is important. It is a time when curiosity far outweighs the boundaries of possibility. In youth, thought and speech are simultaneous. In youth, obstacles are no match for the solutions. In youth, reality takes a back seat to the dream. Long before any coach or player has the opportunity to engage in a championship moment, he dreams about it. Every day, thousands of youngsters act out their fictional championships in cramped backyards, on lonely playgrounds, or in the twilight of darkening streets. Any place is sufficient, really, as long as there is the dream. There always seems to be one more play, one more chance to score the winning touchdown before the imaginary clock reaches zero. In fact, that timer only arrives at zero when the game-deciding touchdown has indeed been scored. That is the beauty of boyhood dreams. They have happy endings. Every once in a while, there comes a time when boyhood dreams can be realized, when the dream about winning it all intersects with the actual opportunity to do just that. For the University of Northern Colorado Bears, that time came on Saturday, December 14, 1996, at Brawley Municipal Stadium in Florence, Alabama. For the first time ever, the University of Northern Colorado Bears would play for a national championship.
Every kid that plays football when he's little has to dream about something like this.
Incredible. It's a dream come true to see everyone here, and my family's having such a great time, and everyone else's parents are just tickled. They're ecstatic. ESPN's over my left shoulder doing some interviews, and it's nice, and it's big time, and what everyone on this team deserves, and we're going to have fun and win national championship.
It's the road to death. Hopefully going to win and bring it home.
It's overwhelming. It's exciting. Right now, it's just, getting all this special treatment right now, kind of gets, if you let it, can get to your head, you know. But right now, we're just trying to really focus down on the game, and it's a dream come true. It's a dream come true, what we've been working on and everything. So, it's the best experience. You can have as a player.
Speechless. It's just amazing to be here and see all the hype around the game, and can't wait to play.
I'm Polish and I'm not the smartest person in the world, but I think everybody realizes it's a big game.
I've dreamed this a lot. Been interested in doing something like this. When you're a little kid, I was thinking in bed last night, how little kids, even if you're throwing a rubber ball off the steps or something like that, it's always 3-2, two outs, bottom of the ninth, we need a hit. In football, it's playing for the national championship. That's what you dream about from the time you're a little kid. And I'm just as into it as if I was still playing. And I know the coaching staff and the players feel the same. That's a terrific moment in our lives.
Every obstacle has been removed except one. Every hurdle has been cleared. Except one. Every mountain has been climbed, except one. Every shred of adversity has been overcome, except one. Every dream has been realized, except one. There remains one final task for the 1996 University of Northern Colorado Bears, winning the Division II football national championship. The season of a lifetime, assembled by the miracle workers, culminates today. And the Northern Colorado Bears will find out if dreams do indeed come true. Welcome to Brawley Municipal Stadium in Florence, Alabama, where today the 15th-ranked Northern Colorado Bears take on the number 6 Carson Newman Eagles in the Division II Football National Championship. Mike Rice alongside Chuck Tennyson on a gorgeous day in Dixie. Sunshine, blue skies, the temperature in the 50s, and an immaculate field awaiting the players here at Brawley Stadium. Northern Colorado's road to the title game has been a grueling odyssey of adversity, perseverance, and ultimately triumph. After a 30-20 loss to St. Cloud State on October 26th left UNC with a 5-3 record and seemingly out of the playoffs, the turnaround began. 6 wins later, and the Bears find themselves on the verge of grasping the prize for which they have toiled for 4 months. Countless hours of practice and study, an innumerable amount of labor and sweat, and extra measures of character and heart have carried Northern Colorado to its first ever playoff victory and subsequent victories, and also carried the Bears to the brink of the school's first ever team national championship in any sport. The Bears, 11-3 in 1996, stand ready, desperately reaching for the top. But there is another team as equally eager to claim the label of national champion. The story of the Carson Newman Eagles is not one of firsts, but rather one of tradition and excellence. Five times the Eagles have won a national crown, and they are ready to place number six securely atop their perch. 12-1 this season, Carson Newman won its fourth consecutive South Atlantic Conference championship, with the Eagles' only loss being a 17-3 setback against Catawba College of North Carolina. Now it comes down to one final game. 60 minutes of football to determine the Division II national champion. For Carson Newman to claim it, the Eagles will have to overcome the miracle workers, a ragtag, never-give-in group of Northern Colorado players and coaches who simply find a way. For Northern Colorado to win the championship, the Bears will have to overcome the Carson Newman tradition and also the Carson Newman Veer offense. How fitting it is that Northern Colorado's road to the title goes through the offense which has given the Bears the most problems over the years. UNC punted on its first three possessions of the game, Carson Newman on its first two. The Eagles' third drive started at the 27-yard line and turned out to be the charm for Carson Newman, but it was not without its anxious moments. Park split wide to the left, the long side of the field. Baxter split behind Allen with two tight ends in the game. Fumble on the snap, ball loose! There's a battle for it back at the 22, and it looks like Allen got back on it as Pat Kimble was right there, but a smidge late.
Quarterback Zach Allen completed a pair of passes to Calvin Christopher, then turned to his team's leading rusher, Tyrone Westmoreland.
Two receivers left, Baxter split, Westmoreland and Morton. They are about 3 yards behind Allen. Now they back up a yard. First and five from the 43. Off the left side, Westmoreland. He's in the clear to the 40. Westmoreland to the 30, the 20, the 10. The Eagles lead at 6-0 as the little general pops on a big touchdown run. 40, make it 57 yards. And Carson Newman is up 6-0.
7-0 Eagles after the PAT, 3:17 left in the first quarter. UNC's next drive stalled at Carson Newman's 37, and Dirk Johnson, who had already boomed two punts over 50 yards, showed off his amazing touch.
Eagles are smelling a fade. Dirk has the green light anytime he wants. He's 8 of 11 running. He will hold it, pooch it away, end over end to his left. Rump won't be able to get it. It bounces at the 10 and just goes out of bounds inside the one. The golden toe comes through again. My goodness, that is unbelievable.
This year I've been trying to really work on trying to, pin
it in a corner when it's in that situation, instead of just trying to pooch it up or just get it through the end zone. And I feel like I've been trying to improve that part of my punting game. And that was just one of those things. You kind of get it down there, and you kind of hopefully you're going to get a good bounce. And that was just one of those cases. I guess I kicked it right that time, and it went out, you know, right where I wanted it to.
Again, the Eagles had trouble hanging on to the ball.
Second and eight from their own three. Westmoreland and Morton split behind Allen, who has Parks, a receiver, to the left. Wide, wide splits on the line. Off the left guard, it's Westmoreland. Fumbles inside the 10. And it looks like the Eagles got back on it, but let's wait and see. Aaron Smith was in there. Zimmerman was in there. Dirk Johnson was in there, and it was recovered by the Eagles, and I think it was Westmoreland himself who got back on it. Second fumble, but the Bears were not able to get on either one.
Trailing 7-0 early in the second quarter, the Bears took over at the Eagles' 42-yard line after Jesse Tan's 12-yard punt return.
Was there anything said about it's time for us to tie this game?
Oh yeah. Everybody on the offense was saying that. We was like, hey, you know, we're in a good position here, good field position. We got to put it in. We can't, you know, just keep lingering and lagging around. We got to, you know, put them away. And I think everybody on the offense felt that way. And Dirk did a great job. The defense did a good job.
Casco left, Zuniga right. Ciccarelli leads Holmes in the eye. Great field position for UNC. Beck turns, gives it to Holmes up the middle to the 40, ripping through tackles and leans ahead to the 36. Second and four from the Eagles 36. A receiver to either side, and Beck drops back to pass. Goes deep down the middle. Wants Hazy. He's there at the five. He's into the end zone. Northern Colorado touchdown. Bears within 7-6 on Beck's 19th touchdown toss of the season.
Great composure that time from Tom Beck. Right in the middle of the pocket. Brad Hatcher, 6'1", 255, defensive lineman, bearing down on him. Drilled as soon as he threw it, but the senior quarterback from Grand Junction hung in there, and that was a strike to Andy Hazy.
It's a play where we send both tight ends up the seam in a cover three, so there's one free safety, and he has to choose one of us which one to take, and he guessed wrong, and Beck, I guess, escaped a hard rush and just put it up, and it felt like it took forever. It was just hanging there. I was like, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Finally, it was just there.
Carson Newman then showed why its offense racked up 255 yards a game on the ground.
Hand off right side, big hole for Morton, up to the 50. Hit by Washington, then gang tackled at the bare 46-yard line. But quickly, a gain of 15 yards. Backs are split behind Zach Allen. The lefty will run the option to the right. He'll keep it himself to the 40 and has a first down out at the 35-yard line of UNC.
But the football proved to be too slippery for the Eagles to handle.
Third down and 10 from the Bear 35. On the handoff inside, it's Rump, and he won't get a thing. Hey, Maya fumbled the ball. Ball popped loose. No signal yet. Was he down? No. Northern Colorado recovers. Scott Zimmerman's on top of it, and now the Bears have their first turnover of the afternoon.
Well, Scott Zimmerman gets credit for the recovered fumble. He won't get credit for the tackle, but he was the one that forced the play. He stayed at home and on the reverse forced Rump into the middle of the defense. Ball popped free, and Scott Zimmerman, right place, right time, made the recovery for UNC.
The turnover gave UNC possession of the ball at its own 37. 10:18 left in the second quarter. The score still tied 7-7.
Second and eight, Bears at their own 39. Offset eye, Holmes and Ciccarelli. Beck wants to pass. Deep drop, looks in the left flat. Now he pulls it back down, runs to the right, gets a block. Now he will throw deep downfield. It is going to be caught at the 20-yard line. Caught by Brian Lusk, the tight end. I think Beck was looking for Grable, who was even deeper back around the 10, Chuck.
I want to tell you what, UNC living right. That pass had no right being caught by Northern Colorado. Tom Beck threw a duck up into double coverage, and somehow Brian Lusk came down with it, and Northern Colorado set up in the red zone for the second time today.
42-yard completion. Lusk's longest catch of the year.
Three rushes later, and UNC was ready to take its first lead.
Beck gets the play from Rod Dobbs, the offensive line coach on the sideline, sent in from the press box, and offensive coordinator Kay Dalton. Ball on the right hash, second and goal from the Eagle 1. Two tight ends, Keith Grable, the wingman, in motion to the left. Second back, pitch to the right. Holmes has an alley, dives into the end zone for the UNC touchdown. And the Bears lead it 13-7 with 7:18 to go in the second quarter.
Great play from Northern Colorado to run outside the tackles. And Carson Newman, everybody in the stands expecting that one to go inside. And UNC crossed him up. Good block as well from Andy Hazy to help spring Billy Holmes into the end zone.
Holmes with his 13th touchdown of the season on the ground.
Down 14-7, the Eagles drove 72 yards in 11 plays.
Eagles will go double tight ends. Howard again in that backfield. Westmoreland the deep man. They'll give it to him up and over the top, and he soars into the end zone for the Carson Newman touchdown. 2:47 left before halftime, and the Eagles are within one at 14-13. Westmoreland scoring for the second time today.
Northern Colorado started at its own 33-yard line with 2:47 to go in the first half, and the Bears mounted a drive.
Beck will give it to Holmes on the draw, slithers to the 35, to the 40, spins to the 45, and pushes to the 47-yard line, taking Cedric Killings and Adrian Porter with him. Beck faces a four-man front, and he will throw. Deep drop, right flat. He's got Ciccarelli, brings it in at the 47, moves to the inside to the 45, and he's tackled down at the 40-yard line by Luttrell and Simmons and Porter, but that'll be enough to move the sticks with 1:19 remaining.
UNC's bid for one more score before halftime appeared to have come up short.
Christopher and Rump are deep. Dirk will stand at his 41 to boot it away. Junior out of Montrose on the western slope. Eagles stack the line, everyone in those navy blue and orange colors. It'll be a fake to Roberson. He'll run it right side. He's to the 40. He's to the 30. He's to the 25 and down to the 20-yard line. And the Bears call timeout with 15 seconds to go in the quarter. Marty English said if we're going to fake it, it's either going to be Dirk or the option to the up man, Tony Roberson. And Roberson goes for, 25 yards. The old high school option quarterback pulls the magic there.
And Tony Roberson looking very comfortable on that option. It really wasn't a pitch man for him to throw to, but he carried out all the motions. And Northern Colorado's in business. A play, Mike, yesterday we saw at the special teams practice a couple of times from the Bears. They worked on it on several different occasions in their two practices this week, and they executed it to perfection.
Tony Roberson's 26-yard fake punt run helped the Bears take the lead into halftime.
It will be spotted by Beck, right hash mark at the 32, a 42-yard effort. Overall, Shower 11 of 19 this year, 1 of 4 from between 40 and 49 yards. That was the 47-yarder he hit against North Dakota State. Takes a quick peek at the uprights. Tom Beck turns towards the center, takes the snap, placed down, kick on the way. It has the distance, and it is good. No time left in the second quarter, and UNC takes the lead into halftime. Bears 17, Eagles 14 on Shower's three-pointer at the gun.
Looking at it, it seemed like the uprights were just so far away. It was just a mile away, but you know, when I put it through and just hearing the screams and you know, high fives from the players, you know, it just like when North Dakota State, you know, I knew I gave the little bit lift to the team, not only with the team but on the scoreboard too, so it was real exciting.
No, nothing's
Carson Newman received the football first in the third quarter, and a UNC roughing the passer penalty on 3rd and 29 at the Eagles' 6-yard line gave Carson Newman new life, and Allen made the most of it. He needed 9 plays to drive the Eagles to the Bears' 14.
Christopher and Ripito split wide to the left, Parks to the right. Westmoreland and Morton again, the Veerbacks. No tight ends on the line for Carson Newman. Allen hollering signals. On the option, he'll keep to the left side, fake the pitch, dives, fumbled the ball, loose at the 7. Who's got it? Northern Colorado comes up with the football. Allen had it for a moment, but at the bottom of the stack, the senior Jim Porter with his 3rd fumble recovery of the year.
Zach Allen with a terrific job on the fake pitch. Absolutely lost the entire UNC defense. Then as he tried to stretch for extra yardage, that ball popped free, and Jim Porter has been all over the field today for the Northern Colorado defense. The Bears sorely needed a turnover, and they got one there to stop the drive.
I think he ran into the back of one of his own players and then started fumbling around like that. I don't think anyone really blasted him or anything like that, but.
And so you saw the ball come loose, and what was your
reaction? Yeah, well, I thought he had it, and I was just covering him up, and then it squirted out right behind him, and I just, curled it in. So,
was there any way that you weren't going to squeeze that one? Just secure it?
Oh, well, actually, he was right below me, so I was trying to get it to Kimball. I was trying to push it over to Pat, so because I thought he was going to – he had kind of leverage on me, so I thought he was going to get it, so I was trying to get it to Pat, so –
But eventually you brought it in.
Yeah.
The Eagles' 2nd turnover set up the Bears at their own 9. Soon it was 4th and 6 from the 28.
Dirk Johnson has had a wonderful day. 255 yarders. Another punt of about 36 yards down inside the 1. Eagles stacking the line, playing for the block. Good snap. Dirk moves to his right. Now he's going to run to the left side. He's got some clear sailing to the 20, to the 25, cuts back at the 30, slips a tackle at the 35, first down at near the 40-yard line. Dirk Johnson is now 9 of 11 running on fake punts, and it's the 2nd fake the Bears have executed successfully today.
Said in the first half that in games like this, when two teams are so evenly matched, special teams can make the difference. UNC has executed 2 fake punts. Dirk Johnson has pinned Carson Newman back at their half-yard line. It has been a special day for the UNC special teams to this point.
Eventually, Johnson did punt it back to Carson Newman, but the Bears' defense was again too much.
3rd down, 11 for the Eagles from the 11. 2 receivers left, 2 to the right. Morton the lone setback. No tight ends in the game. Allen will throw. Drops back to the 4. Over the middle. A diving interception by Bunning. Inside the 25 and the 23. He cut right in front of Rump. And the Bears have their 3rd turnover of the afternoon.
Triple coverage that time from Northern Colorado. And a poor decision by Zach Allen. He throws his 1st interception of the year. And Brad Bunning with a terrific play. And now Northern Colorado set up, Mike, in a position where they can take command of this football game.
The turnover led to another field goal opportunity for Mike Schauer.
Mike Schauer will be called upon again to attempt a long field goal. Hit a 42-yarder just before halftime to give the Bears this lead. Schauer 1-for-1 on the day, and Tom Beck will hold it right hash mark at the 35. A 45-yard attempt for Schauer, who's now 12 of 20 on the year, 2 of 5 from between 40 and 49 yards. His long, 47 against North Dakota State. Beck checks with his redshirt freshman, checks for the snap, reaches for it, receives it, places it down, turns the laces, kick on the way, and good! Mike Schauer does it again! And with 1:29 to go in the 3rd, the Bears double the lead and now take a 20-14 advantage over Carson Newman.
I didn't know it was a 45-yarder. I'd just go out there and kick the ball wherever it was from. And on that case right there, it was a beautiful snap, a beautiful hold on Brian Heil and Tom Beck. And I put the ball through again, so it was great.
Allen tried to rally the Eagles, but ended up having to leave the game on Carson Newman's next possession.
Christopher and Ripito to the right. Parks to the left, Morton and Westmoreland split behind Allen on second and eight from the 35. Option left. Early pitch to Morton. He's going to be smothered by Smith and Kimball and Lopez after Brian Scott crunched Zach Allen. Is Chuck, I think he's hurt back at the 30-yard line.
Zach Allen's left knee buckled underneath him as Scott pounced on him. Great play by Brian Scott. He came through untouched from his linebacker spot, really forced the issue, and the rest of the defense rallied to the football, and I think Zach Allen's hurt.
Allen left the game with a banged-up knee. Normally the backup quarterback, Allen started the championship game because of a knee injury that first-stringer Matt Penland suffered in the Eagles' semifinal win over Cal Davis. With Allen on the sideline, wide receiver Calvin Christopher, the third-string quarterback, took over. Not a good situation for Carson Newman.
Third and eight from the Eagles 35. Backs are split behind Christopher. Receiver to either side, and he wants to throw right away. Pump fake as he rolls right over the middle. It is intercepted by Jesse Tan at the 42 of UNC. So Christopher comes in and throws the pick. That's turnover number four on the day. But now, Chuck, it's time for the Bears to start taking advantage of some of these.
Well, I'm not sure that I agree at all, Mike, with that play call from the Carson Newman bench. You've got a brand-new quarterback in, and once you get down to your third quarterback, maybe even fourth quarterback in Calvin Christopher, I'm not sure you don't play it safe, try and run the football, and if you don't get it, you kick it away to UNC. But to put him in that situation, roll him out and put him on the move and try and throw the football, that's a tough call and very demanding.
Only his second pass of the year.
18 seconds remained in the third quarter when Northern Colorado took over after the interception, and the Bears began to move the ball.
First and 10 Bears, own 43, I set. Back up the middle to Holmes to the 45, dives to the 50-yard line. Feet taken out from under him by John Simmons, but a gain of seven, and that will take us to the end of the third period.
When you're ahead by 6 points in the national title game in the final quarter, you know, third down and two plays are just gigantic, and this one is no exception.
Third and two from the Eagle, 49. A receiver to either side, Ciccarelli and Holmes in the eye. Beck gives to Holmes off the right side. He's to the 45, explodes to the 40-yard line before being knocked down by Porter and Jones. Billy Holmes running with reckless abandon. He picked up nine, and Chuck, he had that look in his eye. Third down and nine for the Bears from the Carson Newman 39. Holmes the lone setback, two tight ends, a receiver to either side. Beck will drop back to pass, plenty of protection. Now he zips it down the left hash mark. Diving grab at the 15! Brian Lusk brought it in, and that'll be a first down. The junior has been unbelievable in a reserve slash starting role this year.
Great adjustment in midair by Brian Lusk. Again, the ball not delivered on target by Tom Beck, but Lusk able to make the adjustment as he had a linebacker on him deep in coverage, and the adjustment wasn't made by the defender, and the Bears are set up.
On fourth and two from the 5-yard line, the Bears summoned Shower again.
Mike Shower to give the Bears a 9-point lead, and these points right here are monumental. Shower's 2 for 2 today, hit from 42 and 45. This will be a 23-yarder from the left hash mark. Tom Beck to hold. Gets the snap, place down, kick on the way. Good. It's the hat trick for Mike Shower in the national championship game. And with 11:20 to go, it's the Bears 23, the Eagles 14.
That looked real close. You know, I went out there. I was a lot more relaxed on that one. And again, you know, good snap, good hold, and nice kick.
Allen returned at quarterback for Carson Newman, but the Northern Colorado defense sensed the desperation and acted accordingly.
To the right, Parks, Rumpf and Christopher to the left. Morton and Westmoreland are the backs. Second and inches from the Bear 31. Allen will throw out of this formation, and this down and distance in trouble, and he is dropped by Jim Porter at the 40-yard line. Chuck, he wanted to get rid of it, but I think wisely pulled it down because he didn't want to throw another pick.
Boy, that is a tough, tough call. Again, you're talking about the strength of this Carson Newman team being able to run the football. You've got second down and less than a yard, and they go back to pass the football. It's beyond comprehension unless they felt like maybe they could surprise UNC.
The Eagles will go on fourth and seven from the Bear 38, Jackson to the right, Parks and Christopher to the left, Westmoreland and Morton the veerbacks. Allen will throw. The left-hander steps up. He wants to run. He wants to throw. He's dropped. He fumbles the ball. It's recovered by Monroe at the 35. Northern Colorado gets its fifth turnover of the day, and the Bears hold again on D. 8:54 to go, and UNC takes over, leading 23-14. Allen had nothing to do, Chuck.
From his 35-yard line, UNC quarterback Tom Beck had the chance to salt away the national championship. Instead, the Carson Newman defense spiced up Beck's afternoon.
First and 10 at the 48-yard line. Two tight ends in the game. Beck changes things up with the Bears up by 9. Beck to run option right. He will keep. He will get to the 50. Cuts back, spins to the 45, and gets decked. And he stays in bounds, and Tom Beck is on the sideline and down.
Yeah, Shannon Courtney, the Bears trainer, next to Tom Beck in a hurry. He absolutely got creamed up for the hit for Carson Newman, John Simmons.
Beck spun, and as he faced up back towards the middle of the field, Simmons lowered the boom, and Ryan Abrahamson has to be readying himself on the sideline, the senior out of Fort Collins. He will get a chance to quarterback in the national title game for at least a play, it appears. 8:06 to go, Bears 23, Eagles 14, as Beck is still on the ground on the near sideline.
Simmons' helmet right underneath the chin of Tom Beck.
Tom Beck has been a warrior, a battler, with heart and toughness that most quarterbacks can't imagine bringing to the position. Yet this play might have been a bit too much. Ryan Abrahamson will appear in his seventh game of the season, 6 of 12 through the air for 75 yards, a touchdown and no interceptions. Beck is on his feet on the near sideline, groggily takes the helmet off with his right hand, limping, favoring his whole left side, it appears, getting attention from Shannon Courtney, and Beck will plant his hind seat on the bench, and it's up to Ryan Abrahamson now, 5'11", 193 senior out of Poudre High School and Merced Junior College. There is a timeout on the field with the Northern Colorado leading 23-14.
Tom Beck is wobbly, Mike. He is on another planet right now.
So Ryan Abrahamson to make an appearance, mainly in mop-up roles this year, but this right now is big time with 8:06 to go. Northern Colorado up 23-14. Beck picked up 2 yards to the Carson Newman. Actually, he picked up 6 yards to the Carson Newman 46-yard line. Abrahamson into the huddle, and now the offense has to rally around him and maybe rally around the offensive line, get those big guys up front opening holes.
The offensive line did just that, paving the way for All-America tailback Billy Holmes.
Maybe the Eagles getting a touch desperate with 7:51 to go and UNC holding a 23-14 lead. The miracle workers right now leading by 9, Chuck, which in a sense is a miracle in itself. That has not happened in the playoffs. It's a new feeling.
Certainly defies the pattern that Northern Colorado has set for itself the last 3 weeks.
First and 10 from the Carson Newman 40. Casco left, Zuniga right. Ciccarelli leading Holmes in the eye. Hazy the tight end on the left side. Abrahamson under center. Carson Newman blitzing. Handoff to Holmes up the middle. 40, 35, and he picks up 5. Simmons and Jones again, and how many times have we called the twin safeties making the tackles for the Eagles today? Second back through, Holmes has a hole, 35, breaks away, right side 30, and he just gets filled by Jones at about the 29, and Billy almost broke it. Mission one is for the Eagles to stop the running game.
Well, and they haven't been able to do so. The Northern Colorado offensive line, as we've said several times, has taken control of this football game. That's another first down for UNC, and every first down the Bears get, you can subtract a couple of minutes off that game clock.
First and 10 from the Eagles 30, Bears up by 9. Holmes and Ciccarelli in the eye, a receiver to either side. Turn and a gift to Holmes off the right side, cuts back and lowers his head and rolls into 4 Eagles at the 26.
UNC offensive line, any offensive line, loves this time of the football game. They know what the play is going to be. They're going to be running upfield and looking for the first guy in a blue jersey and an orange helmet to hit. And if you're an offensive lineman, this is the part of the game that you live for.
When he needed to make plays, Abrahamson showed he was more than capable of getting it done both through the air and on the ground. 4th and 8 at the Carson Newman 27.
Ball on the right hash mark as the Bears break huddle. Zuniga left, Keith Grable to the right. Holmes and Ciccarelli split behind Abrahamson. Will the Bears actually fire the play off or only attempt to draw the Eagles off? Abrahamson will throw. Sets up over the middle. Caught by Halsey inside the 20 and has a first down at the 18-yard line. The Bears pound one more nail in. 4:11 to go. Bears still lead by 9, and Ryan Abrahamson's completion is biggest of the season without a doubt.
Oh, and Andy Halsey, again, we've said it before, he is such a big target over the middle, and he really, really creates some matchup problems. He was on a linebacker again, but just the size advantage that Halsey has enabled that catch.
3rd and 12 at the Eagles 20.
Keith Grable left, two tight ends. Holmes behind Ciccarelli in the I formation. Eagles crowd the line. Abrahamson under center. The senior backup takes the snap. Options to the right. He will keep to the 20. Gets hit by Early. Stays on his feet and struggles to the 11-yard line. He is 2 yards shy of the first.
Beck's able-bodied understudy calmly took the reins of the offense and guided the Bears on a critical drive in the national championship. Shower came on to try and set a title game record by hitting his 4th field goal.
He has made from 42, 45, and 23, and Abrahamson will hold from the right hash mark a 28-yard attempt. Mike Shower, the redshirt freshman who started kicking in the 5th grade, awaits. Snap, placed down by Abrahamson. On the way, and no good, wide to the right.
Shower's miss was the only positive Carson Newman could take out of a demoralizing second half. The Eagles trailed 23-14 with 2 minutes 13 seconds left in the game, and they frantically tried to steal a pinch of Northern Colorado's postseason magic. Ultimately, all Carson Newman found was one final portion of Northern Colorado defense.
A 12-play drive has taken the Eagles from their own 20 to the bare 15, but they are down by 9 points with only 29 seconds to go and no timeouts. Mike Bresky, the Bears defensive coordinator, urging on his defense. Northern Colorado has the title in its grasp as the Bears look to close out the Eagles. With the ball at the 15, Carson Newman breaks huddle. First, make it 2nd and 10. Parks right, Jackson and Christopher left, backs are split. Allen under center, sends Christopher in motion to the right side. Monroe traces him. To the right, Allen rolls, looks, fires left side. It is intercepted by Roberson at the 2. Left sideline to the 20, up to the 30, and Northern Colorado begins to celebrate. Tony Roberson with his 7th pick of the year, the Bears' 6th turnover of the day, and Northern Colorado is 19 seconds from a national championship. Can you believe that? The defense trots off the field. Ryan Abrahamson simply has to touch the knee down, and Northern Colorado will have scaled the heights of Division II college football. Joe Glenn and his son Casey embrace on the sideline. The ball at the 31. Keith Grable way back at the 15. Abrahamson touches the right knee onto the turf. The final 15 seconds tick off. The players filter out onto the field at Braley Municipal Stadium. Final 6 seconds to go. 4, 3, 2, 1. The Northern Colorado Bears are the national champions of Division II college football. It is the stuff reserved for the dreams of youth. Today, the Northern Colorado players and coaches coaches are boys once again with championship dreams now a wonderful reality. Can you believe that? Northern Colorado has capped a grueling odyssey of adversity, perseverance, triumph, tears, dedication, labor and sweat, and put it all together and come out with a national championship. The emotions begin to flow for the Northern Colorado players and coaches. Exceeding joy and exaltation. Unbelievable moments that will be remembered for a lifetime as Northern Colorado has come away with the school's first football and first ever team national championship in any sport. The final, Northern Colorado 23, Carson Newman 14. UNC can now rightly proclaim its place as number one in Division II college football. A large throng of UNC players and coaches and students and fans and boosters gather in the middle of the field around head coach Joe Glenn, who hoists the championship trophy aloft. Helmets into the air. Index fingers proclaiming the Bears as number one into the air. UNC 23, Carson Newman 14. It will never go away. Northern Colorado has claimed the national championship. Get used to that sound. One can say it over and over. And it is always a part of history now. The Bears boosters and fans and players and coaches savoring the moment, passing the championship trophy from player to player. Joe Glenn hoisted aloft, waving his cap in his left hand, securely clutching the championship trophy in his right. Everybody joining in the chant of UNC. As the Bears hold Carson Newman scoreless in the second half and use three Mike Schauer field goals after the score was tied at 14 to win the national championship of Division II college football. They needed miracles the three previous weeks. Today they simply outplayed the Carson Newman Eagles, forced a total of six turnovers, and Northern Colorado will celebrate long into the night as the Bears are number one in a season that went from high expectations to the lowest of lows at Selke Field in St. Cloud to the highest possible point in a place called Florence, Alabama. Northern Colorado 23, Carson Newman 14 in the national championship of Division II. The players and throng of several hundred still gathered in the middle of the field at Brawley Municipal Stadium, passing the championship trophy along, passing hugs all around, exchanging smiles and leaps for joy with one another, trying to fathom the sheer accomplishment of a football team that refused to settle for anything except the top. the reality of a season that will go down in history as the best in UNC is now settling in. The players gather for a prayer in the middle of the field, kneeling down, heads bowed, arms wrapped around shoulders, giving thanks for a blessing which I'm not sure many thought would be bestowed upon them. Northern Colorado 23, Carson Newman 14 in the Division II National Championship. The players, or many of them, still gathered in the middle of the field, supported by five or six rows at least of fans and boosters and players. The thanks have been given, and the celebration again continues for the University of Northern Colorado football team at Brawley Municipal Stadium in Florence, Alabama. Head coach Joe Glenn
now